Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter study of animal tissue. In that we are studying topic adipose connective tissue. Now adipose connective tissue is a form of connective tissue, but it also has other functions. For example, it prevents heat loss from the body. Let's study and find out a little bit more about it. Adipose connective tissue. Now, being a part of connective tissue family, this tissue a little different format is seen, or you can say a little difference is seen in its function as well as in its structure. It contains or consists of large number of fat cells, and the number of matrix is quite less, as well as the fiber quantity is very, very less in this tissue. Nucleus as well as cytoplasm are at the periphery, which gives it a stringent, or you can say a adhere type of fashion when you see it under microscope. Now there are two different kinds of cells that you see in this tissue. The white cells are basically, or white adipose tissues are basically present in adult, or in babies what you observe is the brown kind of adipose tissues. Also, these tissues have major function. For example, they prevent heat loss from your body. They try to keep your body at a certain temperature whenever you are surrounded by a cold climate. Secondly, they act as a shock absorber. Now, when I say shock absorber, for example, if while playing you fall down on a ground suddenly, all your adipose tissue that are present at your muscles, buttocks, at your thighs will try and absorb that shock of falling down, and will prevent your bones and cartilage from getting wear and tear or being broken down. Adipose connective tissue. Now, adipose connective tissue basically contain a large number of fat cells, or you simply say adipocytes. Now, being connecting large number of fat cells, these tissues have matrix as well as fibers, which are considerably reduced in number. The nucleus as well as the grounding substance, which is cytoplasm, is always shifted to the periphery, or you can say at the corners. Thus, it gives like a signet ring of appearance to the cell. Adipose tissue could be two different types depending upon whether you are an adult or in a child. white adipose tissue or kind of adipose tissue is opaque, and it is opaque due to large number of fat cells or adipocytes, which is common in adult beings, whereas brown adipose tissue is reddish brown in color and it is mostly seen in a fetus or a newborn child. So we all were born with brown adipose tissue, and eventually while growing up we develop this white kind of tissue. Now adipose tissue, the common place where this kind of tissues can be located is the dermis or underneath of your skin, around your kidney and your eyeball. The basic function of this kind of tissue is that they act as shock absorbers around kidney and around your eyeball. Whenever you splash that color while playing holi, or that jet of water while playing in garden or anything, that time your eyeballs are protected because of it. It also prevents the loss of heat from body by acting as an insulating material. Now when I talk about insulating material, especially during winters, in winters whenever the temperature outside is very cold and your body temperature has to be maintained at 37 degrees Celsius, you don't have any warmth clothes from outside, that time along with your clothes which you use in winter, your adipose tissue tries to keep the temperature of your body constant. It basically tries to promote you warmth whenever your outside environment is falling cold or it is going colder than your body temperature. Also, adipose tissue, whenever you fall down while playing, running, the adipose tissue in your belly, buttock, thighs, your arms give you that strength or just prevent your bones, collagen, tendons from getting any wear and tear and just giving you protection for long run. Students, this is a structure of white adipose tissue, and it is having a nucleus which is located in it. Students, in this part of the chapter, we came across adipose tissue and how does adipose tissue look like, what's their function and what could be the different types. I hope we are very clear with this concept of adipose tissue. Thank you.